Hello students, this is Swati Deshpande teacher. Today we'll be learning length. The name of the topic is length. See student, the basic standard unit to measure length is meters. See, when we want to measure cloth or a road or a distance between two different cities, then we take help of this length. So depending on whether we want to measure a bigger thing or a longer thing or a smaller thing, we have different measures. So basically length is measured in millimeter, centimeter, meter, kilometer. There are many more, but now today we are going to concentrate on these four right now. Okay? If you want to measure a very very tiny small thing, then we make use of this millimeter. Little bigger thing, then centimeter. Meter, still bigger, and the biggest one is kilometer. See, I am going to draw a small box like this or a bucket like this, and I am going to divide this. The biggest one or the heaviest one, I am going to put it down. Here meter will come, here centimeter will come, and millimeter. Why I am doing this? To help you to memorize or to understand the length easy. Okay, this may not sound mathematical, but for you as a student to understand the relationship between all these four things, this is the easiest way. Okay, now 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. So what is the relation between these two? 1000. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So what is the relation between these two? 100. And 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. So what is the relation between these two? 10. Student, remember, when we are moving this way, we always multiply. Whenever we come down towards heavier thing, we always divide. Okay, if I tell you to find out how much is 5 kilometer, means how many meters, simple as that. So I'm sure you all know this answer, but with the help of this, how are we going to do? Kilometer is given to you. We want to find out meters, so we are moving upwards. So 5, I will, upwards means multiplication, so I will multiply. With which number? The connectivity between these two, that is 1000. So answer is 5000 meter. If you know this, you can solve most of the sums in length. Okay, so this is very very important. Let's take few examples so that it becomes even more easy. First one, it will come on your screen. How many meters is 15.7 kilometers? 15.7 kilometers is how many meters? This is a question. So what can be done? Kilometers is given, we need to find out meter. Again we are moving upwards, so 15.7 into is sure. With which number? Again meter, kilometer, connectivity is 1000. Relation is of 1000. 1 kilometer is 1000 meter. Okay, remember student, this decimal, whenever we multiply by 1000, 100 or whatever, whenever we multiply, the decimal moves towards the right and when we divide it moves towards the left. Here in this case we are multiplying. How many places it will move to the right will depend on this zeros. How many zeros are there? 3. So 15.7. This point will jump 3 times. 1, 2, 3. And then it will come here. Now, these remaining places I need to fill with zeros. So what is the answer? 15700 meters. This is the answer. See how easy it is? Just jumping of the decimal. 3 places. Your answer is ready. Let's move ahead with the next sum. How will you write 12 meter 3 millimeter in decimal form? Into decimal form. Okay? Or rather in meter. How many meters? See, 12 meter is meter only. So there is no tension. 12 is same. 3 millimeter I need to convert into meter. Millimeter is here. I need to convert that into meter so that I can write whole thing as meter. So millimeter to meter, first I need to go here, millimeter to centimeter, I will have to divide by 10. Then centimeter to meter, again I will have to divide by 100. 10 and 100, so it is 1000. 3 zeros, this 1, 2, 3. So from directly if I want to come from millimeter to meter, I will have to divide by 1000, because from here to here I need to divide by 10, here to here I need to divide by 100. So in short, I need to divide 3 by 1000. Now they don't want in the mixed fraction format, they want a decimal. So how can we convert this into decimal? 12 is an integer, so point will come after 12. How can we convert 3 upon 1000 in decimal? See student, 1 is this decimal. After that 3 zeros, so I have 3 places. And in these 3 places, I need to put whatever is there in the numerator. I have only 1 digit. I need to start from this last piece. So 3. So my numbers are over, only 3 was there. So I wrote here, now these places I can fill up with zeros. So my answer is 12.003 meter. Understood how I converted this? 1 is decimal. After that 3 zeros. So in those, so after decimal I will have 3 places because of these 3 zeros. But here I have only 1 digit to place in those 3 places. I need to start from the rightmost position. So 3 I have put here. I don't have anything to put in here. So I wrote 0, 0. So my answer is ready. Okay students, let's go ahead. Next sum. If there are in all 1002 trees on both the sides of a road at a distance of 12 meter each, what is the length of the road? See student, this is my one of favorite sum. See, we always see we should plant trees, isn't it? So this is a tree plantation sum. We have a road. We need to find out the length of the road. Road is there. We don't know how long it is. But we need to plant trees which they have already done. How many trees are there? 1002 trees on both the sides. On both the sides, here also and here also, right? Same distance, same one opposite another, okay? If total there are 1002 trees, means 1002 divided by 2 that is 501 trees on both east side, I mean 501, 501. That's how the addition has become 1002, right? Now what? See student, distance in front of a tree, before the tree, belongs to that tree. Now, this tree has no distance before it. The road starts from here. So, we are not giving any part of the road to this first tree. From second tree onwards, we are giving, how much they are saying? 12 meter. Each tree, two consecutive tree has 12 meter between them. 12 meter, 12 meter, 12 meter like that. But this 12 meter belongs to this tree. This tree has no distance given to it. So, this first tree says, I am not part of your calculation. Remove me out. You have not given me any distance. See, we are doing personification. Have you learned in English? Yes. So, this tree is saying, you have not given me any distance. So, ignore me. I am not part of your calculation. So, we are minusing this one. See, we need not bother. Only one side is enough for us to arrive at the answer. So, only this 501 I am dealing with right now. That from that also I minus the first tree. So, in all I have 500 trees to whom we have given 12 meters, 12 meters, 12 meters. So, in short, 500 trees, 500 times we have given 12 meters because there are 500 trees. And each tree has been given 12 meters. So, 12, 12, 12, 12, 500 times. So, answer is 6000. This was in meter. So, obviously, this also will be in meter. 6000 meter may not be one of the option. Why? Because they might give you 6 kilometer. Because 6000 meter is nothing but 6 kilometer. So, they expect you to immediately make out the 6000 meter is not there, then 6 kilometer you have to choose because it's the same thing, isn't it? So, answer is road is of 6 kilometers. Very interesting sum, isn't it? Let's go ahead and solve the similar type of sum. How many trees are there on one side of a road 1 kilometer long if the distance between two consecutive trees is 25 meters? Here they have given the length of the road and they are telling us to find out how many trees can be planted on one side of the road. Okay. In earlier sum they had given us total trees and they asked us the length of the road. Here length of the road is given and they are asking us to find out how many trees can be planted on one side of the road. See student. 1 kilometer road is there, again trees are planted on, no, here only one side, okay, and two consecutive trees have how much distance between them? 25 meter. So let us first convert this 1 kilometer. Because this is meter, this is kilometer, so convert this kilometer into meter with the help of that box which I have given you in the beginning, make use of that. Okay, so 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. Now we need to distribute to each tree 25, 25, 25. Distribute, so division, so 1000 divided by 25, you can do it like that also, like this. You can do it anyway, okay? So, 25 ones are 25. 25 fours are 100. 0. See, here, if you don't know the table of 25, you can do it with 5 also. 2 times 5 you will have to do. So, no problem. 40. So 40 trees can get 25, 25, 25, 25. So 40 trees. But again, this first tree said, have you given me any distance of the road? No, I am very much in the beginning. Road starts after me. You have not given me any distance. So, I was not part of your calculation, but I am a tree. So, add me. So, total trees, 41. If they would have asked on both the sides, then 41 here, 41 here. 82 would have been our answer. But here they have mentioned only one side of the road plantation was done. So, our answer is 41 trees. Okay, let's go ahead to the next sum. Saili covered a distance of 4 km in 10 minutes. How much distance will she cover in 1 minute? Assuming she is having the same speed throughout. Okay? So let's begin. It's very, very easy. Saili covered 4 kilometers. In 4 kilometers in 10 minutes. Okay. How much distance will she cover in 1 minute? From many, many they have given. 10 is many. Okay. Many they have given. 1 they are asking. From many to 1 it is always divide. So 4 kilometer upon 10. 4 kilometer always try to convert into meter and then 10. So now we have here meters, okay? 10 gone, 10 gone. So answer is 400 meters. So simple. It was just one small division and our answer is ready. Student, the same sum was asked in 2017. So we cannot ignore the probability of asking similar questions in coming years. Okay. This was relatively simple topic. Students, learn that box which I have given you in the beginning. Understand that so that it becomes easy for you to handle the sums. Handle in the sense, solve the sums in an easy way. Okay. So, with this, we are through with topic length. Students, if you have any queries, suggestions, doubts, you can put them in the comment section. I will definitely try to answer all of them. I will definitely come with the new videos. Many suggestions are coming up. So, I will cover all those topics. If you like my videos, share them with your friends, like them and subscribe to my channel. Okay? Study well and most importantly, enjoy studying. Bye.